Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here under exposition of John 1:30 onward. This is he, that he is Christ Jesus, of whom I said, after me cometh a man which is preferred before me, for he was before me. As I said, you know, the Christ was with God. Christ stands for the Word of God, and so Christ was with God before even Adam was created. So John the Baptist is working for the Adam. So Christ Jesus was thus before John the Baptist, and he was the greatest because he was with the God, and it was with the grace of God that we have Adam and all that we see with our two naked eyes. What is inside them that make them living is of God, not the physical bodies. Physical body belong to Yahweh. And I knew him not, that he was with God. So it is with the grace of God that you know, not that by your learning, by your reading books or other thing, or hearing from here and there. No, it is by the grace of God. But that he should be made manifest to Israel. So he came to in Israel, in the mid of the world, so that he make himself manifest to Israel, because the people of Israel, they were spiritually sick, so they needed doctor most than any other country. Therefore am I come baptizing with water. So John the Baptist said that I have come to baptize men with water in the name of Abraham, to make them sons of Abraham, the salt of the earth, whereas Christ Jesus will turn the sons of man into the sons of God. Now remember, Christ Jesus called the sons of man or sons of Abraham salt of the earth because they had the conscience, whereas the people who were sons of Satan, they had no conscience, as you will see how they maltreated Christ Jesus at the trial and afterward. So people who have conscience, they are sons of man, and they are only suitable for being converted into sons of God. And John bear record, saying, I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and it abode upon him. Remember that Christ Jesus was the second anointed Adam, so he was, you know, preferred to the first Adam, for whom John the Baptist was working. As I explained in the previous video, so the second Jesus, being the second anointed Adam, he did not marry, or he did not produce any children, or did not have any secular property, because the secular property belonged to the people of Adam, the tribal cells. So he was far superior to the Adam for which John the Baptist was working, because he was anointed Adam. So the Spirit of God, dove is considered to be the Holy Spirit. So the purpose or the moral of the baptism is hereby put down, or hereby is given, that the Spirit of God landed over Christ Jesus in the form of a dove. So people who John the Baptist was baptizing, they had the Spirit of man. Since this dove represented the very Spirit of God, Holy Spirit. So these people which John the Baptist was baptizing, they had the spirit of man, that they know whose son they were. Because when you become a Jew of the flesh, then you forsake your tribal father. And when you forsake your tribal father, you become a son of Satan of your own free will. So it is a very logical reasoning, and a video has been produced on this subject, quite a few of them. And it abode upon him, and I knew him not. John the Baptist said he did not know him, because Christ is known by the quality, not by seeing. Now John the Baptist belonged to the regime of men, which flesh, which you see with your two naked eye, but Christ is perceived by the third eye of logical reasoning. So John the Baptist was dealing with flesh or with the physical bodies, not with the spiritual. So he did not know that Jesus is the Christ, but with the sign given of the dove landing over him, then assured him that he is the Christ. And I knew him not, but he that sent me to baptize with water, he that sent me to baptize with water, that means God, the same said unto me, that means same told him, upon whom thou shalt see the Spirit descending and remaining on him, the same is he which baptizeth with the Holy Spirit, and not with Holy Ghost, as is written in the Bible. Because most of these people who wrote the Bible, they corrupted it. They were Jewish people, and Jewish are well known for corruption in the scriptures. So this is important, that the sign given by that the dove will be sitting on him, he is the one who is blessed with the Holy Spirit with capital S, which is the very Spirit of God. And so then he knew that he is the Christ of whom he had been prophesied. I have been given the directions or told about. And I saw and bear record that this is the Son of God. So he bears that, confirms that Christ is the, Christ Jesus is the Son of God, or Jesus is the Son of God. Son of God is known as Christ. He was Son with capital S, so was he Christ with capital C. And we who become sons of God with small s, then we have Christ with small c, because in us is the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of men, not of the God yet. At Pentecost, the workers were paid their wage, which was Holy Spirit with the capital S, the very Spirit of God that made them the twin brethren of Christ Jesus. And the next day, after John stood, and two of his disciples, I think I will better leave it to the next video, the next line, it will be better. So here I will summarize that unless you have spirit of man, in which you know who is your father and whose son are you, so you become the salt of the earth, you cannot become sons of God with whom you don't understand. So Father God is only known to those who know their Father in flesh.